This is me.
Just kidding. This is me.
My name is Amanda, and welcome to my podcast where I will be talking about pop culture, music,
film, drama, and fan videos. Hello, and welcome back to my channel, Always Popular. I'm Amanda, your host, and let's jump into this week's episode. For many people in music, you have one-hit wonders who are known for one hit song of their career, and there are certain people who have a long history of having multiple number one hit songs, like Mariah Carey or Rihanna. So today, we're going to be talking about the biggest hit song of the year, Flowers by Miley Cyrus. But the real question is, why did it take so long for Miley to get her first number one hit song? Let's dive in. First of all, just in case, if you haven't listened to the song yet, you probably should.
Yeah, and it's really good.
So this isn't just about how the song got so big and about her apparent breakup with Liam Hemsworth. If you grew up with Miley and her music like I did as a teen and have remembered a lot of her hit songs, specifically the really big hit songs like Seven Things or Party in the USA, wouldn't you have thought, how come those songs never hit number one? Well, before you say anything like she's had a number one hit before, well, technically, this is different. Based on research, the massive song Wrecking Ball that came out amazingly 10 years ago already wasn't a number one hit right off the bat. However, Flowers is her first Billboard Hot 100 debut song. And as for us Smilers, that's why we're celebrating. Miley has been around for a long time and has been making music now for 17 years, which is mind-blowing considering she's my age. So fast forward to this year, where she's ruling the streaming charts and now has the number one hit song around the world. So here are some of the accomplishments she achieved already this year. Flowers has reached number one in over 30 countries, including in the US and the UK, became the most streamed song on Spotify in a week, and the fastest song to reach 100 million plays globally in 7 days, has become a meme for pet owners on Instagram, and has been number one now for 6 weeks. So you could definitely say 2023 is going well so far for Miley. Also, Miley is getting ready to release her anticipated upcoming 8th studio album, Endless Summer Vacation, this upcoming week. In addition, if you have heard the song, you might hear similarities to another huge hit song. Was Your Man by Bruno Mars was sampled into Miley's song, and that's mainly because it was rumored to be a song that they shared together. For the once lovebirds who met on the set of the movie The Last Song, they had a long history together even before getting married. Sadly, that love story ended and went up into flames. So here are some of the references in the song that are similar to Bruno's.
That I should have bought you flowers and held your hand. I can buy myself flowers, write my name in the sand.
It has been reported that Liam cheated on Miley with several different women in their house, and she didn't even know about it. But of course, that's what all the articles on media websites say. So truthfully, we really don't even know the real story behind it. Anyway, also, she has given references in the song that are about her and Liam's past. One lyrical reference is about the Woodsley fire, where her home that she shared with him burnt down years ago. The second reference is about them arguing that led her to realize their relationship wouldn't work. And on top of all of that, she released the song on his birthday, which is January 13th. So apparently the nice guy of him only existed in a movie. Too bad, because now all those memories in that movie aren't going to be the same. Anyway, well, let's not forget the real reason why we're here. So let's walk down memory lane and hear the hits that should have been number one. But first, I have a few reasons on why it took her another 10 years to get a number one hit song. Well, the most obvious one would have to be her competition in the pop field. The past 10 years have had several big and really good hit songs, so you can't get a number one hit all the time, and she had big competition in the past 10 years from people who had top hits in 2013 like Katy Perry, Justin Timberlake, Macklemore, and Ryan Lewis, Fun, and One Direction. There were multiple hits like Thrift Shop, Roar, Royals, Mirrors, Story of My Life, and so many more. Also, Miley did release her chart-topping smash hit Wrecking Ball that year as well, so at least she got one number one hit song of the year. So here's the real story behind Wrecking Ball, is that it debuted at number 50 and made its way up on the list to number one. So therefore, it wasn't a number one debut, unlike Flowers, even though the song was massive when it first came out and did really well. The song Wrecking Ball is still one of Miley's biggest signature hit songs, and even the music video is still memorable till this day. Just like Wrecking Ball, these are the songs of Miley's that I feel like should have been number one. Another huge hit from Miley I believe that should have been number one hit song would be The Climb. Surprisingly, this memorable hit from the Hannah Montana movie soundtrack debuted at number two on the Billboard Hot 100 when it was released. The uplifting and motivational song was accompanied with violins, really gave the song a really good and memorable sound. The lyrics were written really well, and I personally believe it's her best written song in her career. I feel as if the song should have gotten more accolades and awards. This is also one of her signature hit songs, and it's still unforgettable years later and never gets old. Another song that came out in the same year was the dance anthem that is Party in the USA. This also came out 2009 and was released from the Time of Our Lives album when Miley was 17. The song became so big that year, it became a celebration song for many different reasons, whether it was for the 4th of July, celebrating freedom, and having fun during the summertime. The song was also televised when Miley promoted the song on the Teen Choice Awards that summer. The performance was highly criticized for no reason, and it was deemed as controversial because some parents thought Miley was pole dancing when she wasn't, and it caused a huge stir and went on for years. Anyway, besides that, the song was instantly catchy, fun, and had a great carefree vibe in the song. It's instantly recognizable anywhere, and the song was everywhere. Everyone knows that song whether you're a Miley fan or not, and it's fun and irresistible to dance to. And for my last song, I would say Nothing Breaks Like a Heart. Now, the thing is, this song is a feature. Technically, it's not even her song. However, there's no one else I could picture to deliver the vocals to this Mark Ronson song. Mark wrote and produced this song with other people. However, the lead vocals are done by Miley, so it's a bit misleading. I kept thinking it's her song. However, I think it's because she owns this song as if she was meant to sing it, and she makes it her own. With her husky and low vocals, her voice complements the song, and the arrangement is really good. This song is a pop-infused country song, and since Miley has done well in both of those styles of music, it makes sense of why she did it so well. It's also infectious and very radio-friendly and catchy, and I'm surprised that it didn't reach the top 20 on the Billboard Hot 100. Instead, it landed at number 43. However, at least it got nominated for Song of the Year at the Brit Awards. I feel like this song deserves more attention and accolades as well. Honestly, I feel that there are other songs of Miley's that should have done better and should have gotten more attention and love. However, I guess that's what's meant to be. Lastly, before I go, what songs of Miley's do you think deserve better? Once again, thanks for listening and watching, and you'll hear me in the next episode.